Assalamu alaikum everyone. This is Kisra Bibi Muhammad Fayyaz, the student of MSc final year chemistry, here to represent my presentation topic, that is determination of the wavelength of maximum absorption and epsilon max of the aqueous solution of nickel sulfate salt. Before moving ahead, I would like to special thanks to my respectable teachers, Professor Dr. Nasreen Fatima, Professor Dr. Shazia Nisar and Professor Dr. Sadaf Iqbal for giving this opportunity to learn about spectrophotometer instruments. I would also like to thank my team members from Department of Chemistry who make this presentation, because without your contribution, it was not possible to make this presentation successful. Before starting my presentation, I would like you to have a look at presentation outlines. What is lambda max? Why lambda max value is important? How do we measure lambda max? What is molar absorptivity? What is a spectrophotometer, its construction and working? How nickel sulfate solution was prepared? How absorbance were measured, and graphically how lambda max and epsilon max of nickel sulfate solution was calculated. Wavelength of maximum absorption. It is defined as the measurement of absorbance for a particular analyte is preferably made at a wavelength at which a substance or species shows maximum absorbance, known as the wavelength of maximum absorption or lambda max. The graph here representing that absorbance data was collected against numerous wavelength region. This wavelength is representing that species have absorbed maximum light, which is denoted as lambda max. How can we estimate lambda max value? We estimate it by using spectrophotometer. What do we obtain by estimating lambda max value? By estimating lambda max value, we can know that where the component is going to be absorbed, either in the UV or visible region. Importance of lambda max value. This wavelength is characteristic of each compound, means that wavelength at which compound absorbs maximum light, that is at lambda max, so at that wavelength we can determine characteristic of that compound. It provides information on the electronic structure of the analyte. That is, by the help of this lambda max value, we can search our analyte or compound's electronic structure. It ensures higher sensitivity and minimizes deviations from Peer's law. It means that by the help of Lambert-Peer's law, we can minimize deviations. Because absorbance is directly proportional to concentration, means that if the concentration of the analyte is high, so highest would be its absorbance. So if some deviations takes place in concentration or path length, so we can minimize them by using Lambert-Peer's law. Greater selectivity is assumed since the substances that absorb in other wavelength regions are less likely to interfere. How do we determine wavelength of maximum absorption? We determine lambda max by running analyte solution over a wide range of wavelengths. Lambda max is a characteristic property of the compound and gives the qualitative analysis of the sample. While knowing the value of lambda absorbance, we can find out the concentration of solution using Peer-Lambert law. Thus, quantitative analysis is possible. This absorption spectrum representing that absorbance measurements will take place at numerous wavelength region. What is Lambert-Beer's law? It states that the quantity of light absorbed by a substance dissolved in a fully transmitting solvent is directly proportional to the concentration of the substance and the path length of the light through the solution. It means that the cuvette containing a sample solution that is colored, so the amount of light would be absorbed by that solution depending upon its concentration. The Lambert-Beer's equation is A is equals to epsilon into B into C, where A denotes to light absorbance. How much light is absorbed by the material, so it can be defined as the relation between the incident light intensity and the resulted light intensity given by A is equals to log into incident intensity over transmitted intensity. This epsilon denotes to absorption coefficient, which is wavelength dependent. This B denotes to path length of the incident light through the material. This C denotes to the concentration of the absorbing material. The diagram here representing that absorbance is measured by comparing the intensity of light as it enters the sample and it leaves the sample and strikes the detector. The light which is entered into the sample is denoted by I naught, and the light which is leaves the sample is denoted by I. Here A is equal to the negative log of transmitted intensity over incident intensity. By putting this value into the Lambert-Beer's law and then solve for the I, we can get this equation, which shows that exponential relationship between variables that are easily measurables. In this equation, I denotes to light intensity, E is extinction coefficient, D is the thickness of the cuvette, and C is the concentration of the solution. This graph representing that absorbance was measured at different standard solution of concentrations. The line which is passing through this origin representing that as concentration was increasing, absorbance was also increasing. As per statements of Lambert-Beer's law, which says that if the concentration of solution is high, so absorbance would be high. Molar absorptivity or molar extinction coefficient. It is defined as a measure of how strongly a chemical species or substance absorbs light at a particular wavelength. It is an intrinsic property of chemical species that is depending upon their chemical composition and structure. Molar absorptivity or molar extinction coefficients SI units are meter squared per mole, but in practice they are usually taken as mole inverse into centimeter inverse or liter mole inverse into centimeter inverse. In older literature, centimeter square into mole inverse is sometimes used with corresponding values 1000 times larger. Molar absorptivity or molar absorptivity coefficient or molar extinction coefficient is denoted as epsilon, which is equals to the absorbance over B into C. What is a spectrophotometer? It is defined as an instrument that measures the amount of light absorbed by a sample. The extent to which a sample absorbs a light depends strongly upon the wavelength of light. Spectrophotometer working principle. Spectrophotometer techniques are mostly used to measure the concentration of solutes in solution by measuring the amount of light that is absorbed by the solution in a cuvette placed in the spectrophotometer. Components of single beam spectrophotometer. The first one component is the source of radiation. It may be a UV light, visible light, or IR radiation. UV light can be obtained by heating filament, which is filled either by hydrogen gas or deuterium. Second one component is collimating convex lens. Its function is to collect all the rays coming from the source. Third one component is diaphragm, which is used to set the 100% transmittance. The next one component is monochromator. It could be a prism or diffraction grating. Its function is to separate the polychromatic light coming from the source into the monochromatic light, means that it obtains wavelength of one radiation. Another one component is convex lens. Its function is to collect all the transmitting light and focus it to the cuvette where sample is placed. Next one component is cuvette or sample holder. For UV light, it should be made up of quartz. For visible light, it should be made up of glass. And for IR light, it must be made up of rock salt. For example, sodium chloride. If sample is a gas or volatile liquid having low boiling point, so it must be taken in a closed container. If it is a liquid, one drop of liquid must be placed in between two parallel plates of quartz for UV light. For the visible light, it must be placed in between the plates of glass. For IR light, rock salt must be used. If it is a solution, the solvent used for the preparation of solvent must be cyclohexane methyl alcohol. Next one component is a photocell. The transmitted light is incident on it. Photocathode convert these radiation into the current and it can be amplified using amplifier if needed. The last one component is this digital display or readout meter. The current is converted into optical density or absorbance in readout meter. So, value of lambda of radiation can be changed by rotating monochromator.
Assalamu alaikum. Respected viewers, me Zainab Mehboob Ali, a student of MSc final year in organic chemistry, along with my team members' collaboration, are hereby to explain you how we can determine lambda max of nickel sulfate with the help of spectrophotometer. As my friend Khizra had gave you all a clear concept regarding spectrophotometer construction, its principle, etc. Now in succeeding slides, I will explain you how we can actually determine lambda max of nickel sulfate. Moving on towards the procedure of this experiment, let us have a look towards the reagent which we will require for this experiment. The reagents which we will require for this experiment are a green color salt of nickel sulfate and water as blank. Now, moving forward towards the procedure of this experiment, first of all, we have to weigh accurately up to 4 digits of nickel sulfate salt. That is about 0.5 to 0.6 gram on an analytical balance. Secondly, after weighing out the nickel sulfate salt, we have to determine its molarity or we have to recalculate its molarity by using the formula amount is equals to molarity into molar mass into volume divided by 1000. In the third step, we have to prepare a primary stock solution by dissolving the weight amount in 250 ml volumetric flux and label it as primary stock solution. This picture explains how we can prepare primary stock solution. First of all, we have to weigh an amount of solute on an analytical balance. And then a portion of solvent is added to the volumetric flux. Then the mixture is swirled until all the solute is dissolved completely. And then additional solvent is added up to the mark on the volumetric flask. Now, after preparation of primary stock solution, we have to prepare our secondary stock solution by diluting the primary stock solution 10 times in 100 ml volumetric flask and label it as secondary stock solution. This picture shows how we can prepare our secondary stock solution from our primary stock solution. In the fifth step, we have to prepare our working standard of nickel sulfate having concentration 6.0 exponent 5 exponent minus 5 in 225 ml volumetric flux by dissolving the desired volume of nickel sulfate from secondary stock solution. Similarly, we have to prepare our blank solution without adding nickel sulfate in another 25 ml volumetric flask. Now moving forward towards the working of single beam spectrophotometer, first of all, we have to set the single beam spectrophotometer at 300 nanometer wavelength and adjust zero absorbance by putting cuvette containing the nickel sulfate solution and note down the absorbance. Repeat the absorbance measurement by applying 20 nanometer gap of various wavelengths ranging from 300 to 500 nanometer. But make sure every time we have to adjust the blank for getting wavelength of maximum absorption. And this will be identified as lambda max of nickel sulfate. Now, I will explain you in detail how to use single beam spectrophotometer. First of all, let us go to the parts of the spectrophotometer. This is the sample compartment whose lid can be open and closed to place the sample in it. This is the wavelength control knob to adjust the wavelength. This is the zero control knob. This is the transmittance or absorbance control knob, and this is the mode select button by which we can select absorbance or transmittance. Now, before using spectrophotometer, you have to prepare both of your solutions. One is blank solution and other is sample solution. A blank solution is the one which contains everything except for the molecule or the compound you wish to measure. And the sample solution contains the molecule or the compound of which you want to measure its absorbance. Now, before taking measurements, you must set up your machine. First, use the wavelength control knob to select the desired wavelength. Next, use the zero control knob to set the transmittance to 0.0%. Next, open the sample compartment and put in the blank solution cuvette in the sample compartment. Before putting the blank solution cuvette in the sample compartment, wipe off bottom of cuvette so that no other impurities or water droplets interfere in the absorbance measurement to ensure accurate readings. Notice the vertical line on the cuvette and make sure that this line match up with the mark at the front edge of the sample compartment. Now, once you finish with the calibration step, you can take the blank solution cuvette out and now you can place your sample solution cuvette. Make sure that the vertical line on the sample cuvette must match up with the mark at the front edge of the sample compartment. When you remove your sample cuvette, the transmittance must return to 0.0%. Now, for taking additional measurements, you can take as many readings at the same wavelength as you want by simply changing the sample cuvette. But if you wish to change the wavelength, then you must go through the entire calibration methods from the very beginning before taking a new measurement. Now, a friend of mine will continue with this presentation and explain you the calculation and graph of this experiment. Thank you.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. This is Zarakshan Khan. I am student of MSc final year from inorganic section. First of all, I am very thankful to all my teacher who's make me able to show my talent. I am the third member of this group who's cover up remaining topic of this presentation. My presentation part is start from observation. But before start my part, I want to share some points. In this experiment, we find out the lambda max and E maximum of the aqueous solution of nickel sulfate salt. Here we use nickel sulfate salt, which is green color salt, so we don't need to add any color species. When we run nickel sulfate solution in a spectrophotometer, it absorbs light of different wavelength and give different absorbance. By the help of this wavelength and absorbance, we can easily find out lambda maximum and E maximum. Now I am going to discuss observation. The weight of nickel sulfate .7H2O is 0.5316 gram per 250.0 ml, and the molar mass of nickel sulfate .7H2O is 280.86 gram per mole. We make observation column between wavelength and absorbance. Here we have different wavelength and different absorbance. Because we all know nickel sulfate solution absorb light of different wavelength and give different absorbance. The wavelength start from 310 and end up with 490 nanometer. And absorbance start from 0.075 and end up with 0.035. Here we take 20 nanometer difference in between each wavelength. When we plot graph between wavelength and absorbance, we get this type of shape. The wavelength is plot on x-axis and the absorbance is plot on y-axis. We plot different absorbance point on different wavelength. We get maximum point which give highest absorbance, that is maximum absorbance. And the wavelength on this point is called lambda max. Here we get lambda max is 390 nanometer. And the highest and the maximum absorbance is 0.715. Now we come on calculation. In step first, we find out the molarity of nickel sulfate. The formula of molarity is amount multiplied by 1000 divided by molar mass multiplied by volume. Here the amount of nickel sulfate is 0.5316 multiplied by 1000. And the molar mass of nickel sulfate is 280.86 multiplied by 250. 250 is the volume of volumetric flask. So the molarity of nickel sulfate we get is 7.5710 exponent minus 3 molar. In second step, we apply dilution factor and find out the concentration of secondary stroke solution, because we make secondary stroke solution by taking 10 ml of nickel sulfate solution from primary stroke solution and dissolving in 100 ml volumetric flask. So the dilution factor is C1V1 is equal to C2V2. C is the concentration, and V is the volume. Here C2 is the concentration of primary stock solution, that is 7.5710 exponent minus 3 multiplied by 10 V2. V2 is the volume which we take from primary stock, that is 10 ml, and divided by V1, that is 100 ml, that is the volume of volumetric flask. So we get the concentration of secondary stock solution, that is C1, is 7.571 exponent minus 4 molar. In third step, we find out the volume of nickel sulfate stock solution required for 6.0 exponent minus 5 molar in 25.0 ml volumetric flask. So we apply, we use C1 V1 is equal to C2 V2. C2 is the concentration of working standard and V2 is the volume of volumetric flask, and the C1 is the concentration of secondary stock solution. C2, that is the concentration of working standard, is 6.0 exponent minus 5 multiplied by 25.0 ml divided by 7.571 exponent minus 4 molar concentration of secondary stock solution. So we get the V1, that is the volume of nickel sulfate, is 1.98 ml, that is equivalent to 2.0 ml. In fourth step, we find out the molarity of nickel sulfate solution. So we use C1 V1 is equal to C2 V2. Here C1 is 7.571 exponent minus 4 molar, that is the concentration of secondary stock solution, multiplied by V1, that is 2.0, that is the volume of working standard, and divided by V2, that is 25.0 ml, that is the volume of volumetric flask. So we get C2, the molarity of nickel sulfate, that is 6.0568 exponent minus 5 molar. In fifth step, we find out the epsilon of nickel sulfate solution. So we use the formula A is equal to EBC. A is the absorbance, E is epsilon, B is path length, and C is the concentration. Here we find out the epsilon. So we rearrange the formula. So we get that epsilon maximum is equal to maximum absorbance divided by path length multiplied by concentration. Here we have maximum absorbance is 0.715, which we get from graphically, divided by path length, that is 1, and multiplied by concentration, that is the molarity of the nickel sulfate solution, that is 6.0568 exponent minus 5. So we get epsilon E maximum of nickel sulfate solution is 11804.9 molar inverse centimeter inverse. At the last, we discuss result. The lambda maximum of the nickel sulfate, the lambda maximum of the nickel sulfate solution is found to be 390 nanometer, which is obtained from graphically, and the epsilon maximum, E maximum of the nickel sulfate solution is found to be 11804.9 molar inverse centimeter inverse, which is obtained by applying formula. Here my presentation is completed. So thank you so much viewers for watching my video. Allah Hafiz.